So 40% of the world's population live near the coast. So we've got sea level rise, intense storms, and by some estimates, 500 million to 1 billion people will be adversely affected by what's going to happen on the coast. But that's not the only problem. It's a bit more complicated than that. It's not just storms are increasing, sea level rise is going to flood these areas. You have secondary issues such as acidification that's going to damage coral reefs and natural systems. You have changing wind patterns because ocean temperatures are increasing and storms are getting more intense and also more unpredictable. And on top of that, you've got increased rainfall and flooding that is happening deeper in the coast in coastal communities. This is a big problem. And it's a personal problem for me as well. I'm from Singapore, an island state in Southeast Asia, many coastal communities. I worry about what's going to happen to my region, how it's going to impact my family. I've got three boys that, you know, have grown up along the coast. And with that, I've spent the last 2 years helping countries and coastal communities build resilience against climate change. What's the challenge? The challenge is no two coasts are alike. They're highly diverse, physically diverse. They have different distributions of populations, and they're socioeconomically different in terms of the communities that live there. Now, there are many solutions to protect the coast. You have seawalls, storm barriers, we can restore mangroves, and this can protect the coast. The challenge is not so much the solutions. The challenge is actually what's the right mix of solutions that fits the local context and delivers the highest socioeconomic return. Now, let me illustrate this with an example. I worked with a government in Southeast Asia, a country with a large population, diverse set of islands, many coastal communities spread across. And one region in particular faced a complex interplay of challenges, rising sea levels that were causing permanent flooding, increasing storms that were damaging the coast, a large proportion of vulnerable people in poverty living in low-lying areas. On top of that, land subsidence that made matters worse. So we worked with the government to model the impact of climate change over the coming decades to answer questions like which parts of the coast will be flooded, which populations will be impacted, where would schools, hospitals, critical infrastructure be damaged? How would this impact crops, water systems? What would be the impact on natural ecosystems that are important to this country? And importantly, what this did was that it combined climate science with data analytics, with local context, and linked it to socioeconomic impact. Now, to give an example, one particular community faced the risk of 100,000 people potentially being displaced because of increasing sea levels, 8% of the economy, and almost half of the region's wetland reserves were at risk of being damaged. Now, in addition, with this insight, the government was able to better understand the knock-on effects that this would have on public health, on food security, on forced migration. So a lot of issues. So what do you do about that, right? I mean, there's massive exposure and no clear answers to what you do. And in a developing economy like such as this, massive trade-offs that you need to manage in terms of where you deploy resources. So initially, this region was looking at building seawalls, having early warning systems, storm barriers in place that required a fair bit of capital and investment. In fact, what we found was that a mix of solutions were needed. So that included mangrove restoration in selected areas as natural defense, and only in certain parts of the coast, investing to build storm barriers and seawalls. Now, with that, the region could consider, with the same amount of resources, maximizing lives saved, livelihoods protected, and ecosystem safeguarded. And on top of this, the cost of inaction, of not doing anything, also meant massive negative impact for the private sector. So private enterprises would have had billions of dollars of losses with manufacturing, with critical infrastructure, with commercial real estate being damaged. Now, having a visibility on this, the government could then engage the private sector on co-developing and co-funding solutions that benefited both private enterprise and the local community. Now, this is not a problem only in Southeast Asia. A city in West Africa, for example, had similar challenges, but compounded with very dense populations along the coast, severe land subsidence, and drainage challenges that were exacerbated by poor solid waste management in some parts of the city. Now, by integrating climate science, data analytics to local context, and tightly linking this to socioeconomic impact, the government was able to manage the trade-offs on how you would balance the deployment of resources to things such as, you know, do I build more drainage infrastructure? Do I relocate some populations to other parts? Do I build storm barriers? You know, what's the right mix? Now, as you can see, this is a challenging and complex problem. And when you look at it, the challenge is every coast that you look at is different, right? They're socioeconomically, physically different. The most pressing challenges are often in developing countries where they have limited capacity to adapt and they have big trade-offs to manage. On top of this, there are many technical solutions and natural solutions out there. You can protect the coast with mangrove restoration, seawalls, storm barriers. You can accommodate by floodproofing buildings, building drainage. You can relocate people and critical infrastructure. The challenge is not so much what are these solutions, but what's the right mix of solutions for any given context. So by combining climate science, data analytics, to local considerations, tightly to socioeconomic outcomes, decision makers can really balance the trade-offs and take the right actions over time to be able to maximize lives saved, livelihoods protected, and natural ecosystems saved. So with that, we can protect more people along the coast and optimize for the outcomes. Thank you.